Can you describe, I mean, this guy Kenneth Bae now has been held. He's been sentenced to 15 years. You were also sentenced to a lengthy time. Thankfully, that didn't actually occur. What was it like being held captive in North Korea?
Well, it was the most terrifying time of my life. This is a man who was leading a tour inside North Korea, and he had done so previously. He'd been there previously on a number of occasions. So at one moment, his family believes that he is doing his job, and the next moment, they have no contact with him, and they don't know if they will, you know, see him ever again. He is isolated in the most isolated country in the world, with very almost no contact with anybody. I believe he's been able to have contact with the Swedish ambassador. Those visits are extremely brief, and they are meant to be of a consular nature. So, you know, the ambassador will ask about his health and well-being, but there's very little else that, you know, I'm sure he feels extremely helpless.
By the way, the graphic said you were held for 5 years. It was five months before former President Clinton went over there. But, I mean, how do you get through those days when, I mean, did you have contact with your family? I talked to Kenneth Bae's sister. They've only gotten one phone call in all this six-month period. It just happened a couple days ago. I mean, how do you get through those moments where, I mean, I spent 3 days in lockup in Iran, and it was the scariest 3 days of my life. For 5 months, I can't imagine being imprisoned in North Korea.
Fortunately, we were treated humanely, and our conditions were decent. That was after a pretty violent beating, an initial beating when we were taken into the country. I was grateful for our treatment after that when we were treated humanely. Every second of the day is a struggle to get through. I was allowed a total of 4 phone calls to my family. So that's, you know, more than the Bae family has had. And but aside from that, and they're very short calls, I was allowed some letters, and that was a huge comfort. That was really the only thing that kept me going during that time, were the letters that I was sent. I don't know if he's been allowed letters, but I could, you know, I think I sent a series of one batch of letters out to my family and to my colleagues at Current TV, but that was it.